Hi everyone. Yeah, this is Ravi again. Welcome back to my 14th video session on Azure DevOps. Okay, so most of the videos I'm concentrating on every feature of Azure DevOps, and also I'm trying to cover some of the topics related to continuous integration. Okay, so as part of this particular session, what are we gonna cover? Just let me open my virtual machine, okay, where I have stored all the details. Okay, so as part of this session, I'll be covering how can we clone Azure repositories using Git Bash. That means if you want to store the automation scripts or automation code or any development code in Azure DevOps under repositories, how can you push the code from your local machine to Azure repositories by using Git Bash? Okay, and how can we verify the status of your local repository compared to your Azure repository? That means all the files are checked in or not. Okay, and also how can we add any newly added files in your local repository, and then how can we add the same new files to Azure repository? Okay, that is also we are going to cover. And also we are going to cover how can we commit the new files to a master branch of Azure repository. Okay, and also how can we push the code to Azure DevOps, basically Azure repository finally. Okay, so let me just create a project in Azure repository. I'm going to show you this process from the beginning, basically from scratch. Okay, so that you can understand very well the concept. Okay, so let me create a new project in the Azure repository. Okay, so how to create the projects and all these things I have already covered in my previous videos. Please refer to those videos before you proceed with this particular session. Okay, so you click on new project. Okay, I'm just creating a new project called Ecom. Okay, a basic project. Okay, so once I create the project, right, I created. Now, because this particular session is totally about the repositories, about the code management. Okay, how do we manage the code? Okay, so let me go to repositories. Okay, so now this repository is empty. So how can we upload any repository? There are many methods. Either you can clone your computer to your local system by using Eclipse, by using any IDEs, right? You can use Android Studio, you can use Eclipse, you can use IntelliIDEA, so Visual Studio. So these are all the IDEs that you can use to clone this particular empty repository into your system. Okay, or you can directly import a repository from a Git repository, basically from GitHub directly. Okay, let's assume we don't have the code in GitHub. Let's assume we have a code in our local machine. Then you should use this option. Okay, so if you want to import any code that is existing in Git repository, then you have to use this option. If you want to build a code within Azure DevOps, right, you want to write the code in the Azure DevOps itself, then you have to use the fourth option. Okay, so because right now I'm going to show you how to clone, basically how can you upload your code which is in your local machine. Okay, I'm going to show you that. Okay, so first of all, so before proceeding, so what you have to do, you have to install a GitHub. Okay, so how do you install the GitHub? So that I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna cover in other sessions. Okay, so how can we install the GitHub? So you can refer to my other videos. Okay, so before you proceed, you have to install the GitHub Git in your local machine, and then generate an SSH key. Okay, so that SSH key needs to be added here. Wait, let me just show you. Okay, So whatever the SSH key that you have generated, so you need to add the SSH key here. Okay, so this, so I have already added my SSH key, whatever I generated by using Git. Okay, this is my SSH key of the Git. So if you have to add a new key and name the key and copy entire key that has been generated while installing the Git. Okay, so this information you can find in other video. Okay, so once you install Git in your local machine and generate the SSH key, and now you are good to go to upload your local code to Azure repository. Okay, so first, what is our first step? So I need to clone Azure repository using Git Bash. That means this is my Azure cloud repository which is empty. Okay, so what did I do? So I clicked on repository. So this repository is empty. So now you have to first clone this repository. Okay, so before cloning, let me go back to my local machine first. So this is my local machine. I will create one empty folder. Okay, let me create an empty folder called test. Okay, let me create this one. Now I want to store my entire local code here. Okay, what I'm doing now, I'm initiating the Git bash from this folder. Okay, once I initiate the Git bash from here, first I'm gonna clone the empty repository to my local machine folder called test. Okay, let me do that. How can we do that? You have to copy this URL. Okay, let me copy this URL. Okay, and then go to Git and then mention Git clone and then paste the URL whatever we have just copied from Azure repos. Okay, and click on enter. So once you click on enter, it is cloning into your local machine. Okay, one thing is, says you appear to have cloned an empty repository. Yes, I have cloned this empty repository. If you go back here again now, if you see, there is a new folder called ecom has been created because my project name is ecom in Azure DevOps. So that's why an empty folder called ecom has been created as soon as I clone the empty repository, right? That's it. So once that is done, so what you need to do, let me add some code, okay, to this empty repository. Okay, let's go here. Let me copy some code, Selenium scripts. Okay, so this is my one of the Selenium scripts. Okay, let me copy these Selenium scripts to my local folder. Let's assume developer has coded and he has created these many files. Okay, where I have Java files, where I have app files, right, all these things. Let's assume developer has created entire code base repository. Okay, Selenium scripts, basically these are all the Selenium scripts. Okay, now let's assume, now I have to find the status. So if you see here, status of the local repository. Now what is the status of the local repository? Now let me see, Git status. So as soon as you enter Git status and click enter, oh sorry, so I have to basically initiate my, so let me close this. Okay, let me close the Git because I've checked in files in the folder called ecom, right? So I have to initiate the Git bash here. Okay, let me Git bash here. Now click Git status. So as soon as you see, I can, so the, what Git is saying, Git is saying this particular, these many files are newly created which are not added or which are not committed to your repository, because earlier we have cloned the empty repository to your local system and now you have added lot of files. So that is the reason it is saying there are lot of files which are untracked files or not committed files. Okay, so you need to commit these files. Okay, so that means we have now form the status of the local repository. Now I need to add all these files, whatever the files I have added here, right? So these files needs to be added to my empty repository of the Azure DevOps. Okay. How? So I can just enter git space add space dot. That means dot represents what? Dot represents, dot represents, let me just put like this. Okay. Let me, so that you can, let me expand the window. So the dot represents all files. Basically, I am instructing git to add all the files from this particular folder. Okay, I'm adding all the files. So now all the files has been added. Okay, now I need to, once I add all the files, I need to commit all the added files now. Okay, how? You just click git commit. So what we are doing now, we are actually committing the new files to master branch. Okay, so git commit and then hyphen m. So this is my first commit. This is comments. Basically, before you commit, I'm just providing comment. Okay, first commit to Azure DevOps. First commit of Selenium code to Azure DevOps. Okay, so this is my comment. Okay, and then hit enter. So as soon as you hit enter, it is showing each and every file that is, that we are committing. Okay, so now you have to push the code. Okay, because I want to push the code to my master branch, so that is the reason I just provide the command called git space push. By default, git space push by default commits entire code to your master branch. If you want to push the code to any other branch other than master branch, right, sub branches, so you just need to provide the branch name over there. Okay, that means git commit, basically git push origin, and let's assume your branch is branch 1. Git push origin space, let's say team 1 branch. Okay, so if you want to commit the code to push the code to your branch, but now I want to push the code to master branch only. Okay, so what do you do? Git and then push. Okay, click enter. So as soon as you click enter, what it will do, it is going to push all the files to your git repository. So let me go back to, now all the files has been pushed, see, done. Okay, so let me go back to my repository now and let me refresh this. Okay, let me refresh. Okay, refresh. So as soon as I refresh, I should see all the files. See, whatever the files that are in my local repository, right? If I go to app, if I go to app here, so I have all the files here within the app. So that means the entire code base which is in my local system has been pushed to my Azure repository, right? So this is how you can clone your empty Azure repository to your local system, and then developers can start working on the code, okay, by using IDE or whatever. Okay, so here we are not using any IDE. So let's assume developers created code by using some IDE, and all the code has been stored in this particular location, and then we will be adding whatever the new files that are added to your local repository, that you are going to add it to Azure repository by using add command, and then you'll be committing and pushing the code, right? So hope you all understand how can we manage the code, how can we push the code from local repository to your Azure repository. Hope you all understand. So if you have any questions on this concept, you can just leave the comments in the comment box and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.